Hey guys, it's Jessica, and today we're gonna do a video that I frankly, there's no rhyme or reason to it. Well, there's a reason. There shall be no rhyme because it's now October and I'm feeling very fally, even though literally the day I'm filming it, it's like 89 degrees out and I'm wearing a turtleneck. I'm pretending it's fall in my mind because October equals fall and fall equals the best season ever. So with that in mind, I wanted to do a video that kind of gets me in the fall spirit. Hopefully it gets you in the fall spirit. There are a lot of things that I pull out during the fall that I use, that I go out and buy during this time of year every year that kind of gets me in the spirit of things. So I wanted to share those with you. And we're gonna start with a couple of beauty items, but then we are veering off and talking about fashion items, candles, coffee, all kinds of things. If you're into this like I am, let's get into the video. So I'm smiling because everything around me is so like awesome. By the way, before I get any farther, this little fake tree right here that's lit up, this is new this year. Not crazy expensive, and I bought it on Amazon, so I will link it. I'll put it in my Amazon favorites as well. Anyway, I love that, and I've gotten a lot of questions about it. Okay, let's start with makeup. So the entire impetus for this video was this newer palette from Urban Decay. I'm wearing it on my eyes today. This is the Urban Decay Naked Honey Palette. When I opened this for the first time, I thought, oh my gosh, this makes me think of autumn. There's like a little bit of like green and yellow for like leaves, some browns and oranges. It just screams autumn to me. And so when I posted about this on Instagram, I'm like, this is giving me serious fall vibes. Should I do a video? Well, here's the video. This is my version of whatever I'm wanting to call this. I just really am enjoying this. Now, the shimmers, I have not used every shade in this. So this is not like a gleaming review. I've tried this for weeks type of thing. But it definitely gives me those vibes, and so far the shadows I've used have worked very, very well. My favorite is this HBIC. I have all over my lid. I've used this shade in particular almost every time I've used it because I just love it. I have not noticed crazy amounts of fallout, no more so than other shadows I use. And then I used Swarm all over the crease right here. And then another shade I love is Drip. I use on the outer corner and on my lower lash line. So that little bit of brown down there, I love in the fall. And that shade is gorgeous for that. Enjoying it so far, if these colors speak to you and you don't already have anything like it, you might like it, but it definitely makes me feel like fall. The lipstick I am wearing. One of the only times I feel the compulsion to wear liquid lipsticks is in the fall. And I can't explain that, but I have really been enjoying this one. It's from L'Oreal, and I don't know the exact name, so I'll put it on the screen because they never have it on here. But the shade is called I Lead, and it's this shade that I particularly like for the fall. Definitely a liquid lipstick. It's definitely gonna dry out over the course of a day. But it does stay in place. And so for me, like if we're gonna go out to like, let's say a pumpkin patch and maybe we're gonna take pictures and have fun, I'm not gonna be worried about this sliding all around my face while I'm drinking like apple cider and things like that. So that is one reason I like this, but isn't this color the most fall thing you've ever seen? Like, I just feel like it's like that burnt orange, but not super orange and not super brown. It's right in between. And this is one of the more comfortable liquid lipsticks I've found. The next makeup item is a blush I've loved forever. I'm wearing it today. The Benefit Dallas Box Blush. This is kind of pricey for what it is. I always say with blush, you really don't have to go high end. Drugstore blushes are incredible. However, there's something oddly magical about this shade. It looks so boring and neutral, but I like that I can wear it as a blush, but kind of pull it back, kind of like draping in a way. And it's kind of bronzy as well. And I feel like in the fall, this kind of a color just looks so becoming on so many skin tones. Very, very neutral, almost brown, but it never looks ruddy. It looks just like seamless and pretty. This is the second one of these I've owned, and I would buy it again if I ran out of it. It's so, so, so good. Okay, nail polish. I have one particular shade. I bought it last year, but I think it's still available. So if I can find it online, I'll link it. But it's this kind of a like, this isn't it, but it's a very similar shade to this where it's kind of like a rosy, but it's a more like muted toned down rose. And I think that's so pretty during the fall season. This is the Sally Hansen Color Therapy in the shade Soak at Sunset. And I just feel like this particular shade, very similar to what I'm wearing. I love it on my toes, and it has this really pretty sheen to it that just looks so pretty in so many different lightings. And so when I opened my nail polish drawer, this was the first one I thought of. I was like, oh my gosh, like it's just such a pretty, kind of a different take on a fall color, but I love it. Whew, I got through those first four fast for me, so I need to like take a minute. Turtlenecks. There are so many different kinds of turtlenecks, but there's something very fall to me about a really thin turtleneck. It doesn't have to be fitted, but a thinner one, because especially like I was just saying, right now we're at the end of summer where I live and moving into fall. And so the weather is all over the place. Today it's like 80 something degrees. Tomorrow it's supposed to be like 65. And that, you know what I mean? And so with that, I feel like, especially at the beginning of fall, it's hard to predict the weather, assuming you get any fall weather. And that's why I really like them. I like this brown. This is not a color I would typically go for, but I feel like with this kind of a thing, it works, especially with like a pop of color on the lips. This particular one, I just got at Target last month. I can link it below. It's from the brand A New Day. I want to say it was around $20, maybe a little less. And of course, if you have like Cartwheel or Target Circle, whatever they're calling it now, if you have any of those coupons, definitely use it on this. I wouldn't mind buying another color in this. I really don't need it, but I could see myself, because it's really comfy. It's stretchy. It doesn't feel tight in the wrong places. It's definitely fitted though. So if you're not into fitted turtlenecks, I feel ya. Trust me, this one is amazing. I also just got it at Target. It's from Universal Thread and it's a lot looser. And I got it in my normal size small. So I don't feel like you have to size up, but you could try it on in store. It's just super soft. It's a little bit more of like a swing turtleneck, which I also love. They look cute with leggings. I love turtlenecks and there's something about them, especially this thin kind, like I said, that is very fall. Okay. Speaking of that though, I'm also really into like off the shoulder sweaters. When it's winter time, I don't do that as often because I'm cold. Where we live, we have true winters. I feel like fall is the time where I can kind of get away with that without being like chilled to the bone. This one is brand new to me. It literally, I still have the tag on it. I got it from Nordstrom through my trunk club. And I did a whole unboxing and try on for fall on my IGTV, which is still new to me and I'm trying it out. I'd love if you guys would support me over there because I'm like, I think I'm doing this right. Is anyone watching this? Because it is more work. I mean, it's more videos I'm editing over there that you're not seeing here. So definitely check that out. I would so appreciate it. My Instagram is jambeauty89. Anyway, so I tried this one on too and I loved it. So I ended up keeping it just a little bit looser. You can see it on me in that too. Just a little bit looser and cozy. And again, with leggings, man, But let's talk about my true fall addiction, and that would be slide-on mules. I actually have a black pair as well. I have cheaper ones. I have more expensive ones. I love them all. So I am a huge fan. These are older ones. They're worse for wear. I got them last year at Target. They're like super dirty. Maybe I should show you the non-dirty ones. But I love mules because you slide them on. They're so easy, but they look, because they're so in style right now, they just look so chic with outfits. Like if you've got jeans on, they look so cute. You could totally wear them at the skirt if it's still warmer out. I just think they're so versatile, so cute. I have a pair of black ones I got at Target, but they are big. I showed them in that video. And so I need to return them to get the right size. And I'm just going to order it online. I love the Target ones. These are Madewell ones. They are pricier. I think Target sells this color as well. So don't feel like you have to buy the Madewell ones. I do feel like they're made well, I feel like they're made a little bit better, but how long are you gonna wear mules? If you're not gonna wear them that often, you might not be worried about how perfectly constructed they are. And I think the Target ones are freaking awesome too. So I think they might still sell these pink velvet ones. I can link below. I know they're so dirty. I like feel bad holding them up. If you've never tried on mules like that, try them on. I think you're gonna be surprised. Look at them with jeans. You might be like, oh, actually this is cute. Oh, I totally could wear this. Cause that's how I felt going into it. And I'm like, oh my gosh, what in the world? I want one in every color. Okay, last shoe thing, booties. So I own like four different colors of booties, various brands, various price points. Target's the place to go for them. These are from Nordstrom, through the same thing. This isn't sponsored, my gosh. It does sound like it, but no, I just recently got that. I can link these and I can also link some comparable Target ones below. They're just so cute and comfortable. Even when there's a little bit of a heel, if you do okay with a little bit of a heel, I never, like when I'm walking around in booties like this, I never feel uncomfortable, but they instantly make me feel like, okay, it's fall. Like, let's go drink some apple cider and find a pumpkin at the pumpkin patch and go on a hayride. I just love it. Okay, belts. I've been way into them. And again, it was kind of one of those things that I'm like, no, that's not who I am. And then I tried one on and I was like, whoa, like tuck the shirt in the front with a belt. It instantly looks so much cuter. So I get a lot of questions about this belt I wear all the time. I got this from MadisonandMallory.com. I actually get a lot of cute clothes there. Really comparable prices to like Target, I would say. It's owned by 11th Gorgeous here on YouTube, who I adore. So I love supporting them, but they have freaking cute clothes. So support aside, I'm always on there and I'm like, dang it, I cannot place another order, but I freaking love everything they put out. I literally got the belt in this color and in black, but I also recently got a black belt from Madewell from Nordstrom through my trunk club that I also really, really like. You know, if you're gonna tuck the shirt in, I just like putting the belt on here and it just looks so, so cute. I'm finding myself wearing a belt more often than not. Go figure. Also, Animal print. Animal print anything. It was trendy last year. It's still trendy this year, in my humble opinion. This I got from Target, this leopard print, A New Day, kind of crew sweater. Love it. Love it, love it. And they have a lot of different patterns. All of them are cute. So let's talk about the real reason you guys are here, and that's coffee. Now, I've been pretty into this Starbucks fall blend. I don't remember trying this last year. Did they call it the fall blend? Like, I feel like I don't remember ever having this last year, but I got it at the grocery store the other day. I saw it on like an end cap and I was like, so I got that and I just use my like refillable little Keurig thing and make a cup or two each day with this. And it's black coffee, but it's so good. And the other one I really like is their pumpkin spice coffee. So again, it's not gonna be like a pumpkin spice latte. Why am I explaining this to you? Y'all probably already know this. It's still a black coffee, but it just has that twist of pumpkin spice to it. And of course you can always amp it up and get like a pumpkin spice creamer and then you're basically drinking a PSL. Just a sugar bomb, but they're so delicious. Especially if you're a black coffee drinker, I really like the fall blend. My husband really likes it and he is like black coffee all the way. Oh, I wish y'all could smell it. I remember being a kid and being like, we'd be at Kroger if you have one near you. That's where my mom shopped when I was younger. And we'd go in the coffee aisle and I'd be like smelling all the coffee, which is funny because it was later in my adult life that I got into it, but boy, am I into it now. Candles, guys, candles, come on. I'm gonna tell you something. I'm taking a break from Bath & Body Works because their candles are crazy expensive. And if you go to a place like TJ Maxx or Target or basically anywhere but Bath & Body Works, you can get candles even larger with an amazing scent throw for cheaper. Now, I know there are certain scents from Bath & Body Works I will always love. I'm not saying I'm boycotting them. I'm certainly going to buy candles from there again, only when they're on sale. Because when they are not on sale, what is the regular like 3-bit candles are like 20 something bucks? Are you kidding me? I hope no one out there is buying those full price. When they have their sale, it's a much better deal. However, we got a bunch of these candles, which are you kidding, are so cute, from TJ Maxx the other day. $12.99, but it's like double the size of the Bath & Body Works one. So, and it smells amazing. We got another one called Malt Cider. The brand, I don't know if you can just like find this online, but the brand is Scentsational. And then another place, like I said, the soy candles from Target are amazing. I was smelling those in that Target vlog and I meant to buy one or two and I literally just forgot. So anyway, TJ Maxx, Burlington Coat Factory, Target, places like that, get candles there because I just feel like it's a better deal unless you're at Bath & Body Works and you have a coupon and they're on sale. Just saying. Side note though, the best smell, hands down, no argument allowed, is the smell leaves from Bath & Body Works. If you haven't smelled it, man, I would pay full price for that candle. Okay, and then obviously, probably the thing that gets me the most in the fall mood are cute coffee mugs. These are just two random ones I pulled. I have like a Disney one I got there a year or two ago. I think this one we got at like the grocery store. You know how they'll randomly have really cute stuff and you're like, ooh. Mugs like this that are seasonal, I collect them and they're special to me. So sometimes I'll spend a little bit more if it's one I really, really like and I know I'm gonna use for years. And then other times I'll just find random cute ones for $3 at Big Lots. And I'm like, sweet. So my collection is definitely varied with the price points, but they're all my babies and I love all of my fall and Halloween-y coffee mugs. Fall decor goes without saying that having it up gets me in this spirit, you know? And like having a wreath on the front door. Like we have a little wreath we literally bought on Amazon that's a fall wreath. It's actually decently well made and I can link the specific one we have, but just little things like that for me really make a difference. So then when I'm coming home, I see it and I'm like, fall. I'm also a sucker for like window cling-ons, like the little sticky things. Of course, my 16-month-old daughter also loves them. Mostly it's for me. I've always had them. Like even when I was in college, I would have window cling-ons like during the different holidays on my like window in my dorm and stuff. Cause I love that. It makes me think of my childhood. It makes me happy. So little things, whatever it is that makes you feel very fall-y or autumn-y, go for it. Go spend a dollar on some window cling-ons. You won't be disappointed. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching. I hope you'll subscribe. I do 3 to 4 videos a week, beauty and lifestyle. It's quite a mix on my channel. And I hope you'll also come say hi on Instagram. Go check out some of my IGTVs that I've done over there. Again, it's JamBeauty89 over there. And I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.